Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make again a new hair card video. While searching on YouTube, I saw many hair card methods. You may remember that I made a hair card video before. You can check it from the top right card. This time we will use the curl method again to make a hair card but with small changes. I want to shoot a new video as a combination of many videos I would remind myself as. And especially thanks for this method for the JMSG YouTube channel. You can check it and you can see too many different types of hair and characters. And after all of that, you can check my link in description. I will give some hair cards pack link as a Gumroad page. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a curl as a pad to our scene and after that you can scale it. And don't forget to decrease your resolution from the curve settings. You can rotate, scale and place it near of your characters here. And with auto proportional edit, you can activate it from the top 2. You can move some control vertices from your curve. And I will fit it around my character's head. It looks really tiny, but don't worry, we will make it as a plane. Now, you can move some vertices again, rotate and scale them. Now we will add a mirror modifier for our curves. For the rotating some part of your vertices, you can use Ctrl T. And if you want to scale some part of it, you can use Alt S. But we will use them especially when you make it look like a plane and give some extrusion for our nerve pad. And now, I'm not making any extra thing in here, I'm only shifting to duplicate my some curves and placing onto my character's head. It will be look like this for all cover up my head. Now you can choose all of your nerve pad and Ctrl J to join them together. Let's add a new pad curve to our scene again. And shift it to duplicate it. Go to curve settings. Under the geometry, you can give some extrusion. We will use this to set our materials later. You can activate your wireframe for see your density. But before this, choose your character's hair and under the bevel object and choose your thinner line nerve pad. As you see, it will affect it onto your character's head like that. It will give you a plane shape to you. We will decrease them. Before all of this, we have to tidy up something on our character's hair. You can move some vertices, control vertices, with Alt S to scale and choose two of your control vertex and after that with the Ctrl T you can rotate them or with the R you can rotate them with 2. From the bottom left you can see our screencast. I am tidying up my nerve pad for the fitting my character's head. If you want, you can choose two control vertex and right click subdivide if it's not enough for you. For the back parts and with the Ctrl numpad 1, you can set up your view from the back. I am moving my vertices, rotating, moving with G in the y-axis. Choose your nerve pad and decrease your resolution. As you see in the character, these are getting low poly a bit. And after that, with the choosing this middle vertex of your line nerve pad, you can move it and you can give a volume for your hairs. With the changing it or rotating some vertices of your line nerve pad, you can give some hair shape for this. And after all of that, you can continue to set some vertex in your hair cards. Now let's add some materials to this. Go to Shading tab and add a new material. Before all of this, from this Gumroad page, I downloaded this hair texture pack. I really liked it. Thanks for the owner. You can download it freely. And when you download it, the file will look like this. There are too many different color hairs in here. And under the extra folder, as you see, we have some alpha map and normal map. In here, we will use them too. I added all my things to one folder, and with the pressing Ctrl+Shift+T when you choose your principal BSDF, choose all of your maps. Maybe base color cannot become, you can add an image texture with the Shift+A. And connect your color to your principal BSDF base color and open your Materialist hair card. Which color you want, you can choose this. And with the mapping nodes vector, you can connect your image textures vector. Before all of this, under the material settings, you can change your blend mode to alpha blend. We will change it later to the alpha hash, but I want to show some different things to you. Under the mapping node, you can set up your location, rotation and scales value. For the curve, it can be a bit difficult, but don't worry. If you make same process with me, you can use this location, rotation, scales value. But don't forget to check your rotation in Z19. Under the X and Y value scale, you can set up your hair curves like this. After setting up all values, we will use this for our character's full head. And now, you can choose your character's hair and choose your hair material. As you see, it will look like this. That's cast shadow is not good. In Eevee, it looks a bit bad, but we will correct it. In the cycles, it looks good. But before all of this, under the shading tab, I am adding some sky texture for see my textures clearly. As you see this, in the Eevee, it not looks good, but in cycle, it looks really lovely. For the adding extra hairs for the sides, you can press L for your line curve and Shift+D to duplicate it. After that, where you want, you can put it for your character. Again, you can Shift+D to duplicate it. As you see, in the Eevee, it not looks good. I didn't like it. It look really weird. But we will correct it. Go to blend mode and change it alpha hashed. It will affect like in cycles render engine, but we are in Eevee now. From now on, if you want, you can get different hair shape models. Maybe you can make some braids or you can add some curly hair. As I said before, you can use Ctrl+T for your some vertexes, making some twisty look. I will use this method for my other characters too, but if you want, you don't have to make some hair cards, maybe Pixar, Disney or some Overwatch characters too, for making some different blocky part of shading. You can model your planes or other meshes for making hairs. You can use this method too for making game ready characters. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.